So you've created a template, you saved it somewhere in ClickUp, and now you need to change that template and you're not sure how? That's exactly what we're going to be talking about today. To locate your templates, you need to find the template center in ClickUp. This is in a few different locations. The easiest one would probably be to go to anywhere on your vertical hierarchy and click on Template Center and browse templates. If you are in a task and maybe that's a bit easier for you, you can also get to the Template Center by going to the three dots, Template Center and browse templates. You get the idea. There's a lot of ways to get to the Template Center. Once you're inside the Template Center, you can browse all of your templates. Here is where we want to find the template that we want to update. In this case, we're going to update the monthly QuickBooks cleanup. To update this template, to change it in any way, we actually need to create it and then save over the original template. I know that's not ideal, but unfortunately, that's just the way it is right now. So we're going to go to Template Center, browse templates. We're going to select the template that we want to edit. In this case, maybe let's go with a task like our monthly QuickBooks cleanup and click Use the template to edit it. Once we click Use the template, we're going to have to wait a second or so for that template to be applied or created, depending on what you're creating. But here we can see that our monthly QuickBooks cleanup has been added, and we see all of the steps in our process right here. Let's just imagine that this process needs to change for some reason. Maybe we need to add an extra step here. To update our template so that way the next time we use it, it shows up with that correct step, we need to save over the original. So here we added our new step. We're going to assign it to the actual person that we need to assign it to. To save this, we're going to go to Task Settings, Template Center, Update Existing Template. Then we're going to select the exact name of the template we're going to override, and then click Next. This will save over our original. We have the option here to update the name. So if we want to say maybe updated November 1st, we could do that. And then we're going to click Save. But again, this is updating our existing template. The next time we go to load that template, maybe right here, if we go to Template Center, browse templates, find our task template, here's the one that we updated, and we click Use, we should see, here we go, the new name, and we should see that new step added onto this. If we were to do a whole list template, the process is very similar, except we are saving the template at the list level. So if we want to save this whole list as a template, we would do so here. And so on and so on and so on. And now just to answer some FAQs about templates in ClickUp, if I change this template, it will not change ones we've created in the past. This will only be for templates created in the future. And I actually talk about this idea in this older video here when it comes to SOPs. If you're going to be updating something very often, this kind of template management can become a bit unwieldy. So you can check out this video for more on that workaround. The second common question when it comes to template creation is, will I be able to know when a template was updated? Fortunately, this one does have a positive answer. So if we go inside ClickUp, again, find the template center wherever you want to find it, browse templates, let's go to that task one again, we do see the date updated in the corner. So this will help us keep track of when was the last update. So this kind of thing may not be necessary unless you have a major amendment that you want to do. The third most common question I get about templates is whether or not we can share them with other people or share them with other workspaces. And the answer to this one, fortunately, is also a yes. So you can go up to this video here to learn more about public template sharing, which is a small little tweak to a template that will allow you to add it into other people's workspaces or your own secondary workspace. As you can see here, updating a template, it's not the best experience, which is why many people might decide to make a template area in ClickUp and just duplicate things as they need it. But I would still encourage you to use templates if you are going to be using anything with automations, whether that's automating inside ClickUp or outside ClickUp, because a template will allow you to apply a bunch of settings, create a bunch of stuff in one click, which can be a huge time saver, especially when you're doing things automatically. If you are planning on purely using templates manually, manually applying them, manually creating things, then it really doesn't matter. You don't have to use the template center. You could just take a task like this one here, create a template version of it, and every time you have that project, just manually duplicate it. You could do that if you prefer. Just my two cents. I hope this was a helpful quick tip tutorial about how to update templates in ClickUp. If you have your own question about using ClickUp, getting started, figuring out your process, go ahead and drop that in the comments below. Like and subscribe while you're down there to help this video reach more people. And I'll be back probably answering one of your questions very soon with another video about ClickUp process and all the stuff in between. Until next time, enjoy the process.